Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you very much.
Run first! Here comes one in the middle! Hot! I can't help it. They tell me I gotta let run first, I can't help it.
Starting grid, street stock. Like his first time 2007 is going to be a heat race winning number one. He will start on tonight's pole. Street stockers, we're looking for you. Also in the infield area, the mini stock need to be lining up. We're trying to.
This guy stand up right here, Ransom. Stand up. I quit eating popcorn a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the father of Kevin Coffey right here. Let's give him a big round of applause. Not only is he the father, he's also a part owner. He helped get this place up and going. He's put a lot of hard time and a whole lot of work in here. I ain't got no more young in this last one. I got to throw it over here, though. Maybe next week I can get you. Ransom, thank you for all your hard work, brother. We love you.
4, Ronnie Shelton looks like he's slowing down, going into turn 3. Here comes the 46 of Jason Carter.
Oh, the double zero, Mr. Moore's up in the wall up here in turn 4.
$0.06 a dollar. Who wants a t-shirt? Stand up and holler!
The 4 car once again slows going into turn 3. Taking the lead in the 46 is Jason Carter. Starting on the outside pole tonight's modified mini feature, it's going to be the 46 of Jason Carter. Starting on the outside pole in tonight's 12-lap modified mini. Street Stalkers, you're up next. Heat race number 1. Mini stock. You need to be working your way around for your heat races. Mini stock. Starting on the pole in tonight's heat race number 1 in the street stock, it's the 31. Welcome back, Scott Johnson. On the outside in the 8th, it's feature winner Junior Henry. Mini stock, we're looking for you, mini stockers. Like Mr. Rudd and Mr. Butcher are going to have to go work on it for the feature. Up front in the 31 is Scott Johnson.
All right, Archie, we made it through the turn 4 here. We got Mr. Johnson just took the white flag in that 31. We got 3 very fast cars. What do you think about this here, Archie?
I gotta go pay.
Hey,
And it looks like he just took the 31. I just talked to one of the co-owners of that 31 car, Mr. David Ball, a dear friend of mine. Drove trucks with him many years ago. Fine man. So that's their car. Looks like they did their homework. It looks like they just might go away with a feature win tonight. They come here with a smile and a desire in their heart to bring down WFOY fast and open around this big old 4/10 of a mile open dirt track tonight. It's kind of tacky and damp, and that is fast racing. Folks, asphalt will not hold up like dirt will. Is that not right, Mr. Archie?
I don't know.
And they're off, hammer down. Woo, mercy, got a little love tap out, Mr. Price. Oh, looks like we're bumping and grinding. Got past Freddie, done pulled up there in third, and they're going to make it through turns 1 and 2 without a caution. Hallelujah, praise the Lord for that. That event, here they come into turn 3 and 4. We got, looks like Mr. Price. Oh, are we going to have a little love tap coming out of 4? Holy smoke, folks, we're going to complete a lap without a caution. And they're going around and around the hammer down. Got Ray Edwards just snuck out on the tail up there in that wide number 3. I bet his wife, Missy's hollering, go, baby, go. We got to buy some pork ribs this week. Got to have some barbecue. All right, once again, attention down in the pits. Need a mini stock. Let's get ready to rock. Got to keep looking neat in the driver's seat. Tap your feet to the funky B-way. Digging on the radio driving down the road. Come on, folks. Let's get the hammer down. Oh, they done laid the layover on the 93 of Ray Edwards. It looks like they're bumping and grinding. Fast Freddie looks like he's going to try to run the low line down in the mud. And they're starting to lap poor old Ray Edwards. He's smoking a little bit. He's running up on the high side in the marbles trying to run the track in. Looks like he might have a little bit of engine malfunction. But he was nice enough to lay over on the high side. And we have a caution on the front straightaway. Holy smoke. It's the double Buckeye, the double O. That's Mr. Lloyd Hall himself. He's got a flat on the outside right front. He's a weebling and a wobbling. He's a rutting up the racetrack. Don't be doing it like that, son. You're going to cause somebody to have a wreck. Get down low where you can go slow and get in the pits and go, go, go. Put on commercial or residence. You pick up the phone. You call Craig and them fine people. And here they come out of turn 4 down the front straightaway. Holy smoly! Oh, man, somebody's getting sick and tired of the BS on the track. Look like the 49 and the 4, they are mad. They're going to be mad at the fat lady stuck in a can of Diet Coke here. The flag man done. Oh, he's backing up. Let's see what's going to happen here. Oh, and they're off again, slowly but surely. Got a big fat flat on the front, that number 4 does. And the 49 sitting there. I think I seen with a roll of Charmin down there right now. Maybe some White Cloud or Angel Soft or something. He might need a dinner in that 49 car. We're going to open up that front gate and let the holler out here real quick. We've got the big tractor coming out. All righty, folks. We're getting ready to fire up with these mini stocks coming up. Attention. I need all sportsmen. Sportsmen, it is time for your feature. You need to be. On the outside row will be the J1 of, no it is not, it is the number 5 of Rick King. We got that Courtney boy running up there on second.
Got fire coming out of 11.
It's in the fifth. Need all sportsmen on pit road. Pit road. Need all sportsmen on pit road. Looks like the number 71 is going to ease on up here. That's Mr. Brian Courtney himself, followed up by the number 5 of Rick King. After Rick King, you do have the blue. 18, I believe it is, of Sammy Shelton, followed up by the 70 of David Kaywood. As they come around, they're taking the white flag. And it looks like it's going to be the number 71 of Brian Courtney, followed up by the number 5 of Rick King, and then the 18 of Sammy Shelton, and rounding it out will be the number 70 of David Kaywood, and then the 26 of Steve Parrott.
Sportsman drivers, we're looking for the sportsman drivers. Come on around. It's race time. Your feature race is beginning momentarily. Sportsman drivers, we're going racing.
That's right, sportsman. If you got time to lean, you got time to clean. Let's get out here and clean some greens. Let's get ready to go green flag racing. Off your butt and on your feet. Let's get in them race car and get on the dirt street. Go round and round. Hammer down. Looking neat in the driver's seat. Tap your feet to the funky beat. Looking sneak. Grab and get.
Okay, race fans, once again, as we've been begging your patience and you've come through again, as usual, the best race fans on the planet. We are going green this time by. We had a few little issues tonight with the one with the weather and then trying to get all the entertainment in. We try to give you all the entertainment value possible. This time by on the pole in the 66 is Adam Beeler. On the outside is Brian Ormby. All right, Darrell Watson, you got that gorgeous green piece of cloth in your right hand. See what we can do with it. Let's rock and roll, Darrell! Beeler slams the door on Ormby, coming out of turn two, going high up into turn two. Also is the 17 of Rosner's. He takes third position away from Hunter Best. On the point in the orange 66, it's Adam Beeler. Sneaks away to three car lengths over Ormby. At the flag stand, it's two car lengths as Ormby picks up a little bit with the horsepower. But it's Adam Beeler's night tonight. He wants to be in victory lane with his lovely gal, Miss Nikki Vandergriff. Is this going to be their night tonight? Here comes Mark Rosner in the 17, picking up a position on the 00 Brian Ormby, still out front. He's been fast all day, race fans. Now six car lengths over the second place runner, Brian Ormby. It's Adam Beeler on the point. Beeler bobbles just a touch coming out of four, but he gathers it back, going under the flag stand with a six car length lead as he and Ormby in the 00 run the same line. Looks like Rosner sticks it down just a little bit, trying to pick up a position, but he slows going into turn three, and now Ormby picks up a position, or car length rather, on the 66 of Beeler. Green flag action all the way around the racetrack tonight in the Sportsman. Little side-by-side action back in the fifth position between the 14 of Elvis and the 8 of Bradburn. Lickie slams the door on Elvis as they come out of four, still holding off for the fifth position. Meanwhile, a great run in the 007 for Hunter Best. Beeler drives her down in off the berm and has a terrific lap, this time on lap number 6. This time by 14 laps to go. Ormby does not give up. He and Beeler run the same identical line. Looks like that time by Ormby knocked off one car length. So this race is far from over. They may be coming up on lap traffic here to about four more laps. This is going to be interesting. Beeler and Ormby appear to be running identical laps in an identical line, but coming up on lap traffic, you never know what's going to happen in racing. As the 18 of Dyer bobbles with the 49 of Kelso going underneath, and that is going to slow the pace down by your leader in the 66 of Beeler. Dyer and Kelso try to figure it out coming off the berm out of turn four, but this time Beeler slams the hammer on the throttle, and he will go by Dyer to put him a lap in the rear. That's exactly what the 00 of Ormby wanted. 66 having a difficult time with some lap traffic. Looks like the 18 of Dyer will give way to Beeler, and he will take his position as the 49 of Kelso now will be the next to be knocked off as Beeler comes up again on Kelso. Kelso doing his very best to hold him off, and that's what's making Ormby really like his racing because he's cut it down to four car lengths. Beeler gives Kelso a nudge just to let him know he's there. He's going to take the outside line. This time he will clear going underneath the flag stand. And now Kelso slides in between, and he and Ormby. And Ormby now bobbles just a touch coming out of turn two. I don't believe, race fans, that Kelso's making any friends with these sportsman drivers up front. Beeler had one heck of a time and also did Ormby, so it all worked out for the front two. This time by, it's going to be seven laps to go in this 20-lap feature. These racers are doing a fantastic job tonight up front, giving just a little bit of give and take as this show continues on. This time by, it's going to be six laps for Beeler. Looks like the 66 of Beeler and the H1 of Charles Hurricane Hurst bobbled just a little bit, allowing Ormby to sneak up on the outside. And now Bradburn pays back and sneaks down and allows Ormby to now track down the 66 of Beeler. The effort show of Beeler, he's used his entire right side to penetrate through the lap traffic. The entire right side's all caved in, so hopefully if Beeler is able to manage to hold on and get to victory lane and see his lovely gal Nikki Vandergriff, it's going to be a well-earned challenge. Now we have three wide at the mountain right here on the flag stand as the 14 of Elvis is going to try to get it down in the then off the racing groove as a caution comes out with five laps to go. That is what exactly Brian Ormby wanted to see. Leader in the 66. He started on the pole. He sure would love to get down into victory lane and see his lovely gal, Miss Nikki Vandergriff. Let's see what happens. The 00 says maybe not. And a great start for the 17 of Mark Rossner. He pulls up on the bumper of the 00 of Ormby as Beeler stretches out a two-car length lead, diving into turn three. Ormby tries to come on down, but they run the same line once again. You're not going to pick up any speed there when you're running identical lines, identical times. Hunter Best in the 007 is having a fine run up in the top five, running in fourth position. And the 67 of Litke holds down on to number five. Beeler bobbles just a little bit in the corner of two, but he will hold on to the lead. Ormby this time by might take a look down underneath going into three, which he does. He bobbles a little bit, and this allows Beeler to stretch away to a one-car length lead at the flag stand with two laps to go.
thought that was a heck of a move on Brian Olmey. He seen his car getting hot, and he had enough common sense to get down low to where it wouldn't mess the track up for the next class coming on. That is where racing intelligence comes in. Folks, we seen a miracle tonight. We seen a sportsman race with only two cautions. Folks, you don't see that very often here at the Mountain, but these boys are up and learning and coming along real strong and doing good. But coming out next, we got the bad boys of the Modified Four. They're going to put the hammer down, going to get around, round, going to show how it's done, going to line up two by two. That's what they do. Hazmat 66 and Mr. Adam Beeler takes that checkered flag with his beat-up passenger side. That's where he's fighting his way through lab traffic. I bet he'll be happy he gets there and Victor Lane gets his little sugar, Miss Nikki Vandegrift. She looking so fine, like a new glass of wine. His mama over there giving a big thumbs up, clapping and waving. We got our trophy holder, Mr. Whistle David Whistle Phillips himself. I can hear him now. He'll say, here you go, Adam. Here's your trophy.
Thank you, David. On with the starting lineup in the Modified Four.
Beeler's main squeeze down there strutting high in them high heels and that pretty dress and her sash. We got Mr. Whistle himself handing the trophies over to that lovely lady. I'd be willing to bet he might even get a little sugar from our trophy girl. Get a little sugar booger down there in Victor Lane with Mr. Adam Beeler. He's got to go run through them scales first. Got official on the four-wheeler to guide him that way. Next time by, we're going to be going green. Mr. Darrell's going to cut him loose. Back to you, Mr. Arch.
All righty, David. Thank you very much. Also, I want to make a mention to a fine run, the youthful 007 of Hunter Best, his first top three. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations, Hunter. But now it's the Modified Four. Let's get it on. 75, Matt Langford. Looks like the 75 of Langford slows down, and here goes the 46 of Carter around. He may take the lead at the flag stand.
That's right. We also got that 88 coming up here in the Modified Mini. The one and only Kendall White. He looks like he's holding strong in third. Looks like he's ducking down the inside to see what he can find under the yellow number 75 of Matt Langford. Matt Langford's ducking down low. I thought he's going to try to move on. Here comes Kendall White. Oh, I think it's Kenny Arp in fourth. Oh, watch Kenny Arp. I'm guaranteed he's got his toenails out there under the fan. Kendall White's going low, looking under Langford. Langford is a little low. He's up to a quarter fender. Let's see if he can hold him. Oh, he's still looking to the low side. Here they come out, turn four, heading toward the checker. And the 46 is still holding strong.
Super late models, super late models. We're waiting for you. Super, super, supers.
All right, race fans, on lap three, we still got the Jason Carter. Langford done had to slow down. What we've got here is failure to communicate between the driver and the car. But the number 46 of Jason Carter is holding strong. That'll bring the 88 of Kendall White up in the second, and then Kenny Arp in a strong third. Langford dunks into the pits.
Tough luck for old Matt Langford. They sure were strong. I don't know if his tire went down or some kind of mechanical difficulty, but he sure put on a show. But the show is now on the point in the 46 of Carter, and here comes Kendall White.
That's right, Archie. The 88 of Kendall White's putting a move on the number 46 of Jason Carter, and he's getting him down the back stretch. Is he going to hold him? Kendall White has now took the lead, race fans. He comes out of four. They are side by side, but Kendall's going to overpower the 46. They're running into the lap traffic. As they run into the lap traffic, driving the number 13 is Jason Ritchie.
Kenny Arp
just dunked low. He went around Jason Ritchie, followed up by a strong running fourth, the number 47 of Rusty Knox, in fifth place behind Rusty Knox. Holy moly, it's just a dodging and a bobbing and a weaving will be the number 98. One and only in that big number 98. Been here many, many times. Has raced many times here is Steve Ritchie.
Kendall Wright in the red, white, and blue 88 stretches out a six-car length lead over the 46 of Jason Carter as the 21 of Kenny Arp now slows coming out of turn four. It looks like he'll work his racer on into the infield. So now it's left up between the 88 of White, the 46 of Carter, and the 47 of Rusty Knox.
And they're back into lap traffic once again. We have one slow. Darrell Watson's waving the blue and yellow flag. That is a layover flag. Some drivers don't have a clue what it is, obviously. They're ignoring it, not even paying attention. But here we are back up to the front runners, ladies and gentlemen, as they come into turn three and four. It will be the 88 of Kendall White by hard charger number 47 of Rusty Knox. And in the 46, Rusty's trying to chase down and get around Jason Carter. And then the number 16 will follow up into the fourth place of Chris Watson.
White works his way around lap traffic this time by. He will get the white flags. He has a 8-car length lead over the 46 of Carter. And that looks like the battle is going to be for second as the 47 of Knox comes up on Carter. Kendall White now has just two more corners to take before he picks up the checkered flag for his first feature in the Modified Four.
That is correct, Archie. And as they come around for the checker flag, Mr. Watson is giving the one to the lap traffic, and he drops the checker on the 88 of Kendall White. Rusty Knox is trying to put the move on in third for second, but he cannot make it. They'll put the 46 of Jason Carter in second. 47 runner up behind him in third place will be Rusty Knox. And then behind him, I do believe, was the 01 of Brian Gardner. All right, race fans, you have witnessed a miracle tonight. In the sportsman class, only two cautions in them laps. Miss Nikki Vandergriff's taking her little sweet things trophy. Yeah, she's got his trophy, and she is his trophy. So, and he is hers, and vice versa. Might even get a little sugar kissy-kissy going on down there in Victory Lane, near Kentill. But speaking of them sportsmen, we'd like to really thank Smoky Mountain Harley-Davidson and Buell and Enlow Enterprises for being our sportsman class sponsors right here at the mountain, as well as our late models, which will be coming up right now. We'd like to thank very much sincerely from the bottom of my hearts, Mr. Chris Breeden and Realty Executive Associates, Victory Lane here at Grounds. And once again, folks, remember, Realty Executives, Chris Breeden is our Victory Lane Super Late Model sponsor here tonight.
All right, thank you very much, Dave. It's race time, Darrell Watson. Let's see what you got for the Milkman, the Double Deuce, and the 35 of Tony Martin. And that wasn't a good start. Looks like, oh, we got them all bobbled up here. We got stuff crashing up in front of everybody, and we just got us a little melee right here on the starting, on the underneath the flag stand.
Here's your sign.
Fine start that time in the Double Deuce of Mike Weeks. He flies out, gets a car length ahead of 35 as the C5 of David Crabtree has a little trouble over in turn two.
Just stand by, race fans. We'll get a good start here in a minute, and everybody will be happy. We'll go. All right, race fans, next time around, we're going green flag racing. Before we go green flag, I want to wish Ronnie Correll a happy birthday coming up Thursday. He'll be 103. Happy birthday, Ronnie. And we're going green, and it's Tony Martin jumping out for the lead. Milkman trying to push high. David Crabtree's a bobbing and a weaving between one and two. All right, as they come around to take the first full complete lap. They're bobbing and weaving. David Crabtree's trying to hang on in fourth. We got Tony Martin stretched out to a four-car length. 22 of Mike the Milkman's pushing in second with Dusty Carver. David Crabtree's still holding on fourth. Jason Wesson slide tied coming into two. We got the big boy, 007 Roger Best. Tony Scripture's trying to fight his way up into seventh. Is he going to move it? Is it? He takes, he just passed the 29 of Jason Welsham going into one. Welsham bobbles a little bit of lifts. We're already into lap traffic. Standridge is causing the lap traffic on lap number two. Tony Martin's got the hammer down going round and round. The double deuce of Mike the Milkman Weeks. Wishing him a big happy birthday. Tony Martin's coming around. He's fixing to slide by Mr. Standridge on lap number three. As they have completed it, Tony Martin goes high to get around Standards. Standards is going down low. Mike the Milkman Weeks, he's a bobbing and a weaving. We do have a caution. It looks like the J.F. Franklin is up on the berm between turns three and four as our racers try to drift up high to get around this. We're going to start off single file with Mr. Tony Martin. He's going to launch the rocket into the air here tonight. Also, we got the double deuce of Mike the Milkman Birthday Boy Weeks here. Dusty Carver in third. Then we're going to have fourth. It'll be David Crabtree, then the 007 of Roger Best. Then we're going to have Tony Scrimshaw starting up there in the sixth position. Then we're going to have the big boy Jason Welsham. Then Bobby, Big Daddy Bobby Giffen. And we're off with Danny Gibson taking off in about the eighth position. And they are gone like a bullet. They are gone. They have checked out. David Crabtree's trying to find a low ride. Oh, Danny Gibson almost hits a wall between one and two, but they're charging down the back stretch. Andy Standridge is limping along, just going through turn two as the leader's taking the by the flag stand. Holy smoke, we're all rocking and rolling here tonight, Archie. Oh, Millman almost kisses the wall, but he pulls it out. Gives Dusty Carver the upper hand, the advantage. Millman drops back to third. David Crabtree's looking to the inside of the Milkman. See if he's going to give him a little bit of birthday present. Oh, and they're fighting. Whoa, 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 fellas. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Holy cow. They're a bobbing and a weaving. Bobbing and a weaving on this tacky track tonight, folks. This thing is sticking like glue. Even up in the marbles, these cars are not sliding. They are sticking down. That's Tony Martin has done stretched out a five-car length over Dusty Carver. This boy is on fire. We look, got David Crabtree bobbing and weaving, looking down to the inside of the 22 of the Mike the Milkman Weeks with Roger Best charging hard.
Golly, get up.
Tony Scrimshaw, Standards has to dunk low. He gets the layover flag. Tony Martin zips around him on the outside going into turn one. Dusty Carver gets him coming out of turn two. Looks like Martin's got about a four-car length stretch over the Carver with Mike the Milkman about another four cars behind him. Standards is up high. I don't know if he even knows where the layover lane is. Because he obviously is not using it, but here we go. Well, I stand corrected. That is not Standard. That is Mike Lewis. I stand corrected, Mr. Archie. Thank you very much. Oh, Tony Scrimshaw had to check up. They need to give him the layover, the black flag or something. Race fans, who's it going to be tonight? Tony Martin's up in the marbles running high. Bill Howell just went high up into the marbles. Folks are working the berm in. It looks like Dusty Carver. They're coming into late traffic. Jason Cardwell is beside the 15. Todd Hunt pulled out. Andy Standards is finally dunking low. Oh, Dusty Carver just got by the 35 of Tony Martin. This lap traffic's got them all bobbing and weaving out there. They're busier than a one-legged cat trying to cover up a pile on the pros over the lake. And here he's coming back around in the 35, just took over the 9 of Dusty Carver with Mike the Milkman Weeks in third. Got David Crabtree fixing to take over the third position. He's up beside Milkman. Old Milkman pulls ahead coming off turn two. Then you have Bill Howell, who's in lap traffic. Roger Best is trying to get by him. Here we come out turn four. It is Tony Martin once again takes over the lead. All right, Archie.
This time by, we're going to have 10 laps to go for Tony Martin, and he's got the four car lengths on the 9 of Dusty Carver as we penetrate through lap traffic going around Wilbur Hawkins. Coming up on the high-flying 7 of Danny Gibson, your leader is the 35 of Tony Martin. Running second is the 9 of Dusty Carver, running third, the Milkman Mike Weeks, and here comes the C5 up David Crabtree. This time by, it'll be 9 laps to go for Tony Martin.
That's right, Archie. Got 4 more laps to go for Tony Martin. 9 more laps, I stand correct again. Todd Hunt is getting up in the marbles. He almost hit the wall on that last lap. As they're coming in, Tony Martin is coming around, coming out turn four like a thread in the needle, trying to get through lap traffic. He's coming up on past Frank Merritt, followed up by Dusty Carver, who had the lead but lost it back down to second. Mike the Millman Weeks, looks like David Crabtree has finally got by to take over the fourth position. Crab goes high to get around the lap car of Danny Gibson, and here they come, bobbing and weaving, threading the needle. Tony Martin has stretched out a good 10 car lengths over the 9 of Dusty Carver. Mike the Milkman Weeks is in third position with 5 of David Crabtree, closing up fourth. In the fifth position, it looks like it's going to be Roger Best, I do believe. Roger Best, yep, it sure is. Here's your top 5. As we come back in, we're coming up on lap number 20. Next time by, we're going to have 5 more laps. Dusty Martin is really putting on the show. Tony Martin, Lord have mercy, my mouth's running faster than my brain, but here we go. Tony Martin taking the flag stand. 5 more laps to go with Dusty Carver, then Mike Millman Weeks and David Crabtree running up fourth. Roger Best is coming down about a half a lap, but he is in fifth, half a lap down. There are standards going low, filing for the layover flag. He is in at his second time he has been lapped tonight. Fourth time he's been lapped. It don't matter. He's getting lapped left and right. David Crabtree's finally getting around him on the outside. Here comes Dusty Martin charging back down the back stretch. Tony Martin, good Lord, and he's coming up on Tony Scripture. But, man, what a show they're putting on here tonight. We all know who the man with the plan is. Got the steering wheel in his hand, got the hammer down going around, looking neat in the driver's seat, tapping his feet to the funky beat. It's Tony Martin as he takes down the backstretch. Got 3 more laps to go. As they come around, he's going to take the flag stand for the 23rd time tonight. There's Todd Hunt. Looks like he's off the pace. They're going to drop down low. Tony Martin has to go high to get around him. Todd Hunt has just run out of gas or whatever. All right, and here we go. Millman bobbles in the backstretch. David Crabtree's taking advantage of it. What are we going to do? Tony Scripture lays down low. Millman and David Crabtree coming around him on the outside, coming out of turn. All right, folks, next time around, we got the white flag out. Darrell Watson is a-bobbing and weaving out here at them flags. He's showing the white. One to go. Hit drives the checkered. The first victory of the year for the 35 of Tony Martin, followed up by the number 9 of Dusty Carver. Then Mike Milkman Weeks will finish out third. Rounding out the fourth place will be the 5 of David Crabtree. And then the 007 of Mr. Roger Best. God and Mr. Jason Welsh and Danny Gibson give a little love tap out here. Woo, race fans, let's give these guys a big old round of applause, man. That was a fast 25 laps. Sooner or later, they're going to come around here. Our photographer, Mr. Michael Knuckles, is going to hand that checkered flag over for the first feature win of the year to the 35 of Tony Martin. Congratulations, Tony. Let's give him a big round of applause, race fans. And he'll be meeting the ever-lovely Nikki Vandergriff in the Chris Breeden Victor Lane Realty Executive and Associates. You got a house you want to buy or sell, call Realty Executives. I know a couple people personally. Chris Breeden's one. Karen Coffey's the other. They're both sponsors here at the track. They're both upstanding people, and they will help you buy or sell your home. Call them folks today.
Okay, race fans, here we go. This time by the street stock in 12 laps. On the pole in the 31, it's Scott Johnson, flanked on the outside in the 56, fast Freddie Romines. Mini stock, we're looking for the mini stockers. Scott Johnson leading Romines on lap one. Start for the 31 is Scott Johnson, but here comes the Eddie Jr. Henry and the 9 car of Greg Humphrey. On the outside in the 56, it's fast Freddie Romines. Johnson slows a little bit coming out of 4, and here comes the 8 of Jr. Henry. On the outside in the 9, that's Humphrey trying to take a position away from Henry, and he will do it going into turn number 3. Still on the point in the 31 is Scott Johnson, but here comes Greg Humphrey. Man on the move in the 4, it's David Price. He's got 4 feature wins, looking for number 5. Going around lap traffic is the 31 of Scott Johnson. And so he has the 9 of Greg Humphrey. And here comes the 8 of Junior Henry, running 4th in the 56, fast Freddie Romine. Your race is for the lead. In the 9, it's Humphrey trying to take away the lead away from Johnson. This time by will be halfway home for the Street Stockers. David Price trying to look under the 56 of Romines for 4th in the 4 car with 4 feature wins. But up front, this time by it's going to be cross flags for the 31 of Johnson. In tow, it's still Humphrey, nose to tail. Still battling for 4th, it's the 56 of Romines and the 4 of Price, and Price will take off the position this time going into turn 3. 31 and Johnson, the 9 of Humphrey, and now here comes Junior Henry with no one in between. He's going to see which groove to take to try to pick off second position. Johnson goes high, coming out of four. This time by, it's going to be three laps remaining in the street stock. Humphrey going high. These guys are doing a tremendous show for the street stock fans. 31, the pole sitter is Johnson. And the 9 of Humphrey. Flag for your leader in the 31 is Scott Johnson. As the 93 gets spun around coming out of two. This will be a caution and a checker and a white flag all at once. This time by, it's going to be caution, fellas. Caution, 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 caution. Your winner in the street stock is going to be the 31 of Scott Johnson. Running a fine race in second in the 9 of Humphrey. And coming home third in the street stock is the 8 car of Junior Henry. So the first time down at the mountain in 2007 pays off for the 31 of Scott Johnson. The 31 of Scott Johnson takes the checker flag away from three-wheeling photos as he waves to a bunch of fans down here. Congratulations.